Hey everyone, and welcome to Premiere Basics, a weekly series where I'll teach you the ins and outs of Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, do you know that feeling where you're watching a movie, you see a cool effect, you wonder how they did it, and then you find out that it's actually super simple to create? Well, great, because today I'm going to show you three super simple and fast effects to spice up your movies or short films. And maybe, just maybe, I'll add an extra one if you keep watching until the end. We're gonna start off with an effect that you can use for action movies. Now imagine that your character drank too much, took drugs, or got hit in the head. Now this will make him a bit fuzzy, trippy, and drowsy. It looks like a difficult effect, but it's actually not. And there's actually two ways that we can do this. The first one is with the echo effect, which we can find in the effects library in Premiere Pro. But this effect is really heavy and the playback will go super slow. So another way to do this is by duplicating your original clip multiple times and placing them on top of each other. Now you can do this by holding Alt while dragging. Next, we're going to offset each clip a couple of frames. I'm doing 3 frames here. You can do this by holding Alt and the right arrow key. Now give every layer the screen blending mode, except the original layer on track number 1. And BAM! There we have it, a echo effect, which is a bit trippy. Now next, we have a fun effect for romantic or sci-fi movies. Whenever you're thinking about the past and a flashback appears on screen, they have this kind of dreamy look. Well, we can make this in a few clicks. Once again, we're going to duplicate our clip. And you can do this 2 times again. Now make sure that they are placed above each other. Next, we're going to the effects library and look up the directional blur effect. We're gonna drag this on the top clip, and from the effect controls panel, we can adjust the blur length. I'm going for about 25, and the direction is gonna be around 45 degrees. Then I'm going to put the blend mode to screen. Next, I'm going to copy the directional blur effect and paste it on the middle clip. Here I'm going to change the direction until I create a kind of star shape on my screen. And once again, I'm gonna put the blend mode to screen, and voila, here we have our dreamy look. Now this works best with highlights and bright areas. So it's also ideal for music videos or concert recaps. Now let's jump into our last effect, which is actually not really an effect, but it actually kind of is. Well, it's actually a cheat code in a way. Whatever. Well, we all have that favorite movie that we love the color grading of, but we will never be able to replicate it because we kind of suck at it, right? Well, get a screenshot of that movie or that specific scene, place it in your timeline, and place your own shot next to it. Then we go into the Lumetri panel, and if you can't find this, then have a look in the window menu and select Lumetri color. Okay, so once we're in there, we go to the color wheels and match, then we select comparison view, then scroll on the left screen until you find the screenshot, and then go back and select apply match, and boom! All of our colors are matched with the ones of the movie. Now, of course, this will not really affect the exposure and contrast of your shot, so we have to adjust that for ourselves in the basic correction tab. But that's something that we can do, right? Now, if you're still watching, awesome, I love you. So let me show you my love by giving you one extra effect. Do you know the 4-color gradient? Well, you might have heard about it or used it before, but did you know that you can create your own flares or light leaks with it? It's super simple. First, we make an adjustment layer, which we can do by right-clicking in the project panel and selecting New Item, Adjustment Layer. Or we go to the New Item icon and select it from there. Then we place it in our timeline, and then we look up the 4-color gradient effect in the effects library. Now place it on your adjustment layer and make 3 of the 4 colors pure black. Now the last color is going to be the one you choose your light leak to be. I go for blue. I love blue. Then I'm going to animate the point by placing a keyframe, which I can do by clicking the stopwatch right here. And then I'm going further in time and adjust the property values. Now it's an animated light leak. Throw it on top of another clip, select the screen blend mode, and bada bada bing, bada bada boom, here we have our own light leak. Now let's go out, shoot a movie, and use these effects to edit a masterpiece. Now talking about movies, they are made with a team. And working in a team can be frustrating when you're not doing it right. Hell, imagine editing with a team. What a nightmare. But we found some great ways to do it and made a class about it, which you can find on Skillshare. Now it's both about editing as a team in Premiere as about setting up servers, even for freelancers. So definitely check it out by clicking on the first link below which will give you 2 months of free access to Skillshare. Now, I'll see you guys next week, and as always...
Cut!
Huh?
Stay creative.